Hi, I'm Dr. Ron Lemenager from Purdue University Beef Extension Specialist. And what we're going to do today is we're going to have a primer on grass tetany for cow-calf producers. First of all, we need to talk about what is grass tetany. It's a nutritional disease in beef cattle that has a common name of sometimes grass staggers, lactation tetany, wheat pasture poisoning, winter tetany. But the bottom line is that it is characterized by low blood magnesium levels in the animal. The question then becomes, what are the typical symptoms of grass tetany? Oftentimes we find these animals dead out in the field because the events of grass tetany oftentimes take place from start to finish within 2 to 3 hours. And what we'll see if in the earlier stages of the onset of grass tetany is animals that have trembling muscles. You'll see twitching of the face, ear, and flank muscles. These animals are extremely excitable, and as you look at them, they will sometimes have a wild stare in their eye. They're typically uncoordinated, and they will have a stiff movement or gait. They will oftentimes grind their teeth. In the later stages, they will go into violent convulsions. And ultimately, at the end of this process, you'll see the animal in a coma, and it'll oftentimes be dead. So when does grass tetany typically occur? It typically occurs in older cows with calves that are approximately 2 months or younger. And the logic here is that happens when these cows are during their peak lactation. It's typically not seen in the first calf heifer, although it is possible. We also see grass tetany taking place usually on lush early spring growth, typically on cool season grasses such as orchard grass and fescue, and also we'll see grass tetany on fall seeded small grain pastures like oats and rye and wheat when they're grazed in the early spring. We'll also see grass tetany take place 5 to 10 days after the onset of colder, wetter weather. Now, why is grass tetany a problem on lush spring forages? Well, part of the problem is the plant itself, the grass plant. And what we'll typically see is reduced magnesium uptake by the plant when we have the following conditions. Number one, high potassium levels in the soil. In other words, we've added a lot of potassium fertilizer. When the nighttime temperatures are less than 55 degrees Fahrenheit. And this is all aggravated by high nitrogen levels in the soil. Okay, so again, a fertilization issue. That's a little bit counter to where we really want to be because, you'd like to be able to put on a significant amount of nitrogen early in the spring to promote forage growth. And so this is a balancing act. Lush spring forages create complex interactions that also affect the animal. For example, magnesium, which is really the mineral that we're concerned about in grass tetany, its absorption is reduced by high potassium intake, low sodium intake, and higher fatty acid intake. And these are all characteristics of this young, lush, vegetative growth in the early spring of the plants. They're high in potassium, they're typically low in sodium, and the fatty acid profile is a little bit higher. All of these affect then the magnesium absorption. The other problem that we have is that energy absorption is also reduced in the animal because of the high soluble protein intake caused by eating this lush vegetative plant, and the low soluble carbohydrate intake that's associated with that plant. Now, a cow with symptoms of grass tetany is really an emergency situation. It requires early detection and treatment immediately upon discovering the event. What we need to do as producers then is we need to call your herd health veterinarian immediately when you find a cow that you suspect having grass tetany. What the veterinarian will do is they will give an intravenous infusion of calcium and magnesium, typically in a dextrose solution, to bring these cows back out of that. And the recovery, if found early enough with this treatment, is pretty successful. The problem is, remember, we only have about a 2 to 3 hour window from the onset to the time that these animals typically die. So our timing is really critical. when you think about moving or handling these animals, make sure that you do it extremely carefully, because these animals, as we indicated earlier, are very excitable, and any excitement that you add to that animal will add stress and could cause sudden death. The ultimate goal in grass tetany is its prevention. The grass tetany season is typically in that very early growth of the plant, typically in April and May. And what we need to do as producers is we need to give some consideration to using higher magnesium-containing mineral supplements. And these supplements need to contain some salt. Salt will improve magnesium absorption and the intake of that magnesium component in that mineral. One of the things that we need to understand is that typically the magnesium compounds, like magnesium oxide, is not very palatable. And so we need something to enhance its palatability. And salt is one of those things that will do that. We also need to think about what the cost of this is going to be. And for a 60-day early spring grazing season, the total mineral cost for all minerals that you're going to add would be something in the order of $5 or less. The other thing that we can do during the grass tetany season is to supplement with energy. And one of the common recommendations is to either add corn or dried molasses or something that would increase the palatability of that magnesium-containing mineral. Okay, so you're adding energy right to the mineral itself. The alternative to that is to add hay or corn or some other high energy feed when the grass is what we call washy, or it's extremely high in water content. Typically when the grass is in that stage of the first 6 to 8 inches of spring growth. The other thing that we need to think about as producers is we need to avoid adding high levels of nitrogen and potassium to the soil, or having a high nitrogen and potassium soil content or an analysis. Now, what are some of the feeding considerations when we put mineral out for cows? Well, first of all, if we're going to have a magnesium-containing mineral out, intake is extremely important. That means we need to put the mineral feeders in the correct areas where the cows are going to use it. We need to have enough feeder space available for the cows, typically 15 to 20 cows per mineral feeder, so that all animals have ample opportunity to consume mineral. We need to keep the mineral fresh. In other words, if we've got mineral in a feeder and it gets rained on or whatever and it starts to cake, mineral consumption will go down. So we need to think about adding mineral more frequently to keep it fresh instead of putting out a week's supply or a month's supply at a time. The other component of this is that typically we will see increased intakes when we use mineral in its loose form compared to having a block form of mineral. One common on-farm mineral mix that we could use, about 25% dical, 25% trace mineralized salt, 25% magnesium oxide, and 25% of an energy source and palatability enhancer. And that palatability enhancer energy source could be ground corn or dried molasses. Now, to wrap this up, one of the things that producers need to give serious consideration to is a good year-round mineral supplementation program. It's important for a variety of reasons. One of the things that we know is that mineral requirements change during the growing season as forage quality changes, and also as the cow goes through different stages of production. In other words, peak lactation, you know, into the dry period, etc. The body can store some vitamins and minerals, okay, for use at a later time. So if we've got a good mineral program and the body stores are adequately created, when we get into a high demand time, some of those vitamins and minerals can be pulled from the body stores and kind of offset some of the problems that we might have. We can't rely totally on body stores, however. We have to provide minerals adequately during the course of the year. And obviously, minerals are important from the standpoint of herd productivity, not only from the prevention of grass tetany, but also in the areas of fertility, conception rate, weaning rates, the milk production of these cows, gain in feed efficiency, and also in the immune function and disease resistance, particularly of the calves, and how those animals respond to vaccines, etc. So that kind of wraps up our grass tetany as a primer for our cow-calf producers. Thank you, and have a good day.
This presentation is a production of the Animal Science Department at Purdue University.